Hi dear students, I am Sridhar from Government Women's College, Tumkur. Today I am going to make a video on stationary states and energy eigenvalues in quantum mechanics. Before going to start explanation on this topic, I would like to request you to like our videos and subscribe our channel Sri Tutor, and also hit a bell icon to get the notifications of the recent updates of the video. So let us start this topic, stationary states. What is that stationary state? In quantum mechanics, we are describe the quantum systems. In that quantum system, there are number of quantum states are there. So in such quantum states, that quantum states are described by any wave function. So that wave function, if you solve that wave function, you will get number of physical observables or number of different solutions of different physical observables you will get. Depends on what type of the operator you are applying. The position or momentum or energy or kinetic energy or total energy or potential energy. All these physical observables are independent of time. A quantum state in which all the physical observables are independent of time, then such quantum states are called stationary states. The stationary, which says that static or rest. So when it is at rest, as the time elapses, it is always be there. So it is stationary. So in that sense, we can say that all the physical observables in the quantum states are independent of time, then such quantum states are called stationary states. And this stationary state corresponds a single definite energy. So this corresponds to the state, means the stationary state has a single definite energy. So when you get the energy or total energy, so by solving the wave function, so you will get a single and definite energy. There is no variance at all in this stationary states. And also this stationary state is also called as eigen state or energy eigen state or energy eigen vector, like that. The stationary states are quantum states that are the solutions to the time independent Schrödinger equation. I said that in the Schrödinger equation, we can simplify it into a time independent Schrödinger equation. We are get the one more equation, that is time independent Schrödinger equation. This time independent Schrödinger equation can be applied to the that stationary states. So therefore, these stationary states are the solutions to the time independent Schrödinger equation, because all the physical observables in the stationary states are independent of time. So therefore, these are all the solutions to the time independent Schrödinger equation. So let us consider a Schrödinger equation, one dimensional Schrödinger equation. So when the Schrödinger equation comes into our mind, it should be a time, both time and space dependent. So both time and space dependent. So let us take the time dependent Schrödinger equation. This is the time dependent Schrödinger equation. So minus h cross squared by 2m d squared psi divided by dx squared plus v into psi is equal to I h cross d psi divided by dt. It is a one dimensional, so because the psi is a function of x, the space coordinate x only. So therefore, we have to be write d squared psi divided by dx squared and d psi by dt. The differential operator, we have to be write d. So let us call this is the equation number one. So here, m is the mass of the particle and v is the potential energy. And all these are all independent of time. Potential energy, so usually it depends on the space coordinates and the time, but here we have to take the time independent potential energy. So it is depends only on x. So now equation one can be solved by using the method of separation of variables, because psi is a function of both space coordinates as well as the time. So psi is a function of x and t, because we are considered only one dimensional, so therefore it is x and t. Otherwise, if it is all the spatial coordinates, you have to take psi of x, y, z and t. But here one dimension we are considered, so therefore the wave function is depends only on psi, only on x and t. So let us consider one such function psi of x t. Psi of x t is a function of all the two variables x and t. We can write this into a two different wave functions. So one is the psi of x, it is purely depends on the x, and phi of t, it is purely depends on time. So let us call this is the equation number two. So divide the equation one, the previous equation, what we are called the equation one, that is the time dependent Schrodinger equation, that is divided by psi of x into pi of t and substitute for psi. So wherever the psi is there, so you have to substitute psi is equal to psi of x into psi of t, and the whole equation is divided by psi of x into psi of t. So therefore you will get, so 1 divided by psi of x into pi of t, because we are dividing the LHS term. So therefore 1 divided by psi of x into pi of t, and in the bracket minus h cross square divided by 2m d squared by dx squared into, wherever the psi is there, you have to substitute psi of x into pi of t, right, psi of x and pi of t, plus v of x into, wherever the psi is there, you substitute psi of x into pi of t. So therefore v of x into psi of x pi of t, which is equal to I h cross divided by psi of x into pi of t. So because we are dividing psi of x and pi of t on both LHS and RHS term, so therefore I h cross divided by psi of x into pi of t. You can see this is psi of x and pi of t into d by dt of psi. So wherever the psi is there, you have to substitute psi of x into pi of t. So now we are get this one. And if you simplify and separate all the variables by taking the time variables into the RHS term and the space variable into the LHS side, then you can see here you are differentiating with respect to x, so therefore pi of t is constant, and here pi of t is there, you can bring outside, so then pi of t will cancel. So now here it becomes 1 divided by psi of x into minus h cross square divided by 2m t square psi of x divided by dx square plus v of x into psi of x, which is equal to I h cross as it is, we are written as it is, and here you are differentiating with respect to time, and the other is constant, so therefore psi of x will comes outside, and this both psi of x will get cancelled, it will becomes I h cross divided by phi of t into d by dt of phi of t. So now you can see this is purely a time dependent, it is purely a space dependent. So both you can call this as equation number 3. You can observe the LHS side and RHS side of the equation 3 as only a single variable. So LHS side is having the space variable and RHS side having the time variable. So thus we can equate, because both are independent, it is purely a space and the RHS is purely a time. So therefore we can equate both the terms to some constant. Let us take that constant is the energy E. So say E, both are equal, so which is equal to E. So therefore we can write, so this is the RHS term, this is the This is LHS term, this is RHS term, so both are equated to E. Let us take this RHS term. So now you can call this is equation number 4. So let us take the RHS term, IH cross divided by pi of t into d by dt of pi of t, which is equal to E. So if you solve this by taking the pi of t into one side and on simplifying, you will get the pi. Pi will be equal to e to the power of minus I e t divided by h cross. It is purely dependent on time. There is no space variable in this expression. So pi is equal to e to the power of minus I e t divided by h cross. So we are not again writing in the bracket t. So therefore we know that, because so every time is not no need of writing the t in the bracket. We know that this pi is dependent on t. So therefore pi is equal to e to the power of minus I e t divided by h cross. Let us call this as equation number 5. And also in the LHS term, the space dependent is there. So in that expression, 1 divided by psi is there, and that will be equal to E. So therefore psi, we are taking this psi into this side. So therefore minus h cross divided by 2m d squared psi divided by dx squared plus v to psi is equal to E psi. Let us call this as equation number 6. So you can see this is equation number 6 is a time independent Schrodinger equation. So that solution can be written as, so whatever we assume the wave function psi of xt, so that psi of xt can be written as psi of xt is equal to psi of x into wherever the pi of t. So you can write e to the power of minus I e t divided by h cross. So let us call this is equation number 5. So these are all the stationary states. So because the equation 6, what it is, purely depends on space, is not depends on time. So this equation 6 is called a stationary states. So whenever we want to calculate the expectation value of such stationary states, you will get a constant. The expectation value of position, expectation value of momentum, expectation value of energy, or Hamiltonian, or the potential. So whatever the physical observables, if you measure the expectation value of any physical observable in that stationary states, so and those are all constants. So thus equation 6, whatever we derived, it is purely a space dependent, this time independent Schrodinger equation. So thus equation 6 can be written as the H Hamiltonian operator, H cap psi of x is equal to e to the power of n, en into psi of x. So H cap is the Hamiltonian operator, and that will be equal to minus h cross squared divided by 2m d squared by dx squared plus v of x. So you can call this as equation number 9. This represents the Hamiltonian operator. Equation 8 is eigenvalue equation. So because here h cap is the operator, this operator operates on the wave function psi. So it yields a constant with the same function. So therefore it satisfies the eigenvalue equation. So therefore this equation number 8 is called the eigenvalue equation, and E is whatever En we have written. So n gives the state, different states. So n, so therefore En is the eigenvalue. So here we can write the En is the energy eigenvalue. So the general solution for equation 1 for discrete set of eigenvalues. Equation 1 again, our general solution for different set of eigenvalues, discrete set of eigenvalues. That means whenever you solve the equation, you may get the different values of eigenvalues, because the equation 1 is depends on both time and space. So therefore you may get the different energy eigenvalues. So therefore for such equations, we can write the solution psi of xt is equal to summation n cn psi n of x into e to the power of minus I into en t divided by h cross. So this en cn is constant, hn is the corresponding eigenvalue, psi n is the eigenfunction. That's all. Thank you.